Hi, welcome to the Ecofina Financial Channel, and it's another edition of the Global Economic Outlook. My name is Philip, and I'll be taking you through some of the major events making the round in the global economy. So in this week's edition, the main story is titled Main Street Challenges Wall Street for Supremacy in the Stock Market. That's strange, but that is exactly what is happening right now. No one could have predicted that some so-called amateurs could ever challenge the professionals on the Wall Street for supremacy. But in fact, not only are they challenging them, they are currently winning. The world of investments has normally been known to be within the domain of professionals, and no one could ever expect that they would be given a run for their money by some people who, just come together and make some quick decisions. But welcome to 2021, where a new order has emerged. So on the social platform Reddit, investors have banded together and are deciding on buying stocks which have been heavily shorted by the Wall Street heavyweights. This move is forcing the heavyweights to unwind their short positions, of course, at a loss. Short selling, is a sophisticated investment strategy, and is used when investors or the professionals expect that the price of a stock will fall. But if the price goes up instead of falling, then they have to unwind their position at a much higher level, which causes them to lose a lot of money. So when these Reddit investors, decided to buy into some stocks, what it did was to push the price up. And when the professionals who have shorted these stocks, try to unwind their position, of course, it forces the price further up, which is actually what is happening now. So it's like forcing their hand to do what they didn't want to do. And now a lot of them have recorded severe losses. So some of the stocks that have been affected so far, Reddit, include GameStop. It's a video game, a mortar and brick video game store. Then you have AMC Entertainment, Nokia, BlackBerry, and some other ones. Right now, of course, the prices have skyrocketed for GameStop. For instance, it's gone up by as much as 1,700%. Nobody knows how long this will last for. There are signs that they are trying to, do the same for some other things as well, including silver. But let's see how that plays out. But one thing that we know this has achieved is that that made people on the Wall Street know that they are not the only repertoire of knowledge, and people even on the streets can also challenge them. So the voice, of course, of the main street is ringing loud on the Wall Street. So that's it for the main story. But we also cover other stories in the Global Economic Outlook on the global scene with Apple again posted record revenues of about $111.4 billion in the first fiscal quarter of 2021. For Apple, the first fiscal quarter is between October and December 2020. Which is impressive. Again, Apple is just leading the way. Also, in Norway's sovereign wealth fund, it is the largest sovereign wealth fund in the world. It is worth several trillions, a couple of trillions. They posted, $123 billion in investment returns, and then most of the investment was in the stock market and also in the electric vehicle market, basically Tesla. So they made a lot of money last year. It's the second highest return they've gained since the inception of the fund, which is great. Also, we talk about Joe Biden, the American president, wants to make the entire federal vehicle fleet in America electric vehicles. So what it means is that all the vehicles in the American federal system will be changed to electric vehicles. So what this means is that there is a, you know, a new market, a great market, you know, for the electronic, for electric vehicles. And so their stocks has to be ones to watch because this should drive them up greatly. Also, we talk about Faraday Future is an electric vehicle company. So they are merging with Property Solutions and they will be going public soon. And then we talk about Barcelona beating Real Madrid to top the Deloitte Football Money League. There are other names there like Bayern Munich, Manchester United, Liverpool in the top 10. But Barcelona remains top. Also on the Nigerian scene, we talk about the Central Bank of Nigeria retaining the monetary policy rate at 11.5%. And then Echelon Capital, a venture capital firm, wants to invest $1 million in Nigerian startups. You can check their site to apply for this investment. And then we talk about CowrieWise. They are doing really great. They've just secured $3 million in funding from a group of investors led by Kuna Capital. So that's it for the main stories. For those who love to go on vacation, we also captured the best places to visit in Asia. We've looked at Europe, we've looked at South America, we've looked at North America. So this edition is focused on Asia. So that's it for the Global Economic Outlook this week. You can read the print edition through the link that we'll share on the comment section. Also, if you need advice on how to invest or manage your wealth or assets, you can reach us, Ecofina, via email or telephone, and then we'll be able to discuss further. So you can subscribe to the channel for regular updates. We'll see you next week.